and how I got to know Akron. All right. So I moved here 1992, right before the big blizzard. I grew up in the desert. We once closed the whole city down because we had half an inch of snow. And I was in junior high, and I think I missed half a year of school because of that. No joke. Like, we, you know, you'd go outside and you'd check for tarantulas and scorpions, and that was okay, but snow, it killed us. I didn't drive for almost 5 years when I first got here, because snow can kill you. But when I got here, we moved into Copley, right at the intersection of I-77 and 18, which is Market Street. It was a very professional neighborhood. That's how it was described to me. We're all professionals. And I was raising children. I had little girls that I was, you know, trying to raise into adults. And all these professionals had no time for my children or for me. So I had to go find a place to hang out where the professionals didn't have to endure my children. And so I would go to Fairlawn. There's a park off of Trunco. It's a really nice park. There's an entrance to the trails and the national park. It's beautiful. But every time I went with my daughters, the other mothers would come and sit next to me, and they were really nice, really sweet. But the conversation always ended up with, so how long have you been a nanny? Or how long have you been babysitting these kids? And it's like, I'm not the babysitter, I'm the mom. And that, you know, kind of led me to believe that there was something about the way I looked that made them think that I was not their equal. College educated, I worked my way up to management before I stopped working to raise my kids, and I was not their equal. Some of these mothers had barely graduated from high school, and I was still not their equal because I didn't look like them. I drove a Mustang, 1991 Mustang, and they were driving minivans, and I was still not their equal. I could outrace any of them, and I was still not good enough to be anything but, hey, can I have your phone number? I'm looking for a babysitter this weekend. All right. And we ended up moving to Pittsburgh. Great job opportunity for my husband. And so we moved to Pittsburgh. We were there for two years and very segregated. We lived in a black neighborhood. We went to a neighborhood church that was Italian. Our neighborhood church was supposed to be the all-white church, but they didn't have a children's room or a children's program because they just didn't need it. So we went to an Italian neighborhood for church. We gave our money to church in the white neighborhood, and we lived in a black neighborhood that we moved into because it was the only neighborhood that we could move into with more than two children. We were there 2 years. I loved it. I loved it. People accepted you. It was very segregated, but they accepted you for what you were. They didn't judge you. They didn't say you couldn't come in, that you had to stay out. They just let you be. And we moved back to Akron because we wanted to raise our kids in a more inclusive environment. We had three daughters, found out I was pregnant when we got here, and we moved into a neighborhood off of Marion Hills. And every time I would take my daughters for a walk, every time I went for a walk by myself or walked the dogs, anytime I went down my own street, I could see windows, curtains open, I could see curtains close. Anytime I went for a walk, somebody was watching me, somebody was keeping tabs on me. Everybody knew that I was the new person in the neighborhood. For like 10 years, I was the new person in the neighborhood. And the only thing that made me different from everybody else was that I was not white. I was not black. I was, again, not white, not black. I was different. I was not the norm. In Akron, I was not the norm at all. I spoke Spanish. I was Asian, Native American, and I was not white. My children looked white. My children had no problems until the parents met me. And then, oh, I'm sorry. My son can't play with me today. Oh, I'm sorry, you know, we rescheduled the party. And And so that was my inclusion into Akron. That's how I came into being part of Akron, knowing that I didn't belong here or here or here or here. And then something strange happened. You know, people started to act differently around me. They started asking me, hey, what's your name? Where do you work? What do you do? And I stopped thinking, oh, they are asking me these questions because they want to see if I can babysit or see if I can clean their house or see if, you know, I can be of any service to them. And I started answering their questions the way I would answer them if I was at home. You know, like myself. So what are you? I'm Yoli. No, really, what are you? American? Yeah, we're all American, but what are you? Human, right? Sometimes it would take 5 questions before I would break down and say, okay, do you really want to know what I am? Do you have that kind of time? You know, my grandmother's German. My grandfather was Apache. My other grandfather came from the Yucatan Peninsula, a Spaniard with Native American blood. My grandmother, her family were executioners from China. Do you really want to listen to the rest of the story? And the answer was always yes. That's pretty cool, you know? Tell me more. And the more I told that story of what made me different, the more people in Akron, the more my neighbors, the friends that I was making, became more accepting of me. And the more I became more accepting of myself in this strange environment. Because again, I grew up in the desert. I grew up surrounded by people who were my color. Even though in that environment, I was also not like them. Because, you know, I don't look Hispanic, I don't look Mexican, I don't look like somebody from the Southwest, I just look different. But once I stopped thinking of myself as being different and started thinking of myself as just being me, the easier it was for other people to accept me, and the easier it was for my community to accept me, for my city to accept me. And little by little, you know, 20 years later, I walk down the street and it's like, hi, Yoli! And the curtains don't open and close. People don't peek through their blinds anymore. They see me, they come out and say hello. And, you know, in a world where sometimes your differences keep you out, sometimes your differences bring you in. And in Akron, that's exactly what's happened.